We're going to talk about cancer treatments. And the first thing we're going to talk about is chemotherapy. What is that? What is chemotherapy? Chemotherapy is a drug treatment that uses powerful chemicals. They're designed to kill fast-growing cells in your body. Since cancer cells grow and multiply much more quickly than regular cells in the body, cancer is easily targeted by these drugs. There are a lot of chemotherapy drugs out there that are available. And chemotherapy drugs can be used alone or in a combination, a cocktail, if you will, to treat a wide variety of cancers. So using these things, putting them together, sometimes a little bit of this, a little bit of that helps fight whatever cancer you may have going on right now. Chemotherapy treatment carries a risk of side effects, of course, and we've all heard of these horrible side effects. Some chemotherapy side effects are kind of mild and treatable, such as skin damage, nausea, things like that, while others can cause pretty serious side effects, such as renal damage, like kidney damage, liver function problems, permanent hearing loss, permanent hearing damage, high blood pressure, and even heart failure. So these are pretty serious side effects. And that's why it's so terribly important. If you go back to one of my other videos where I talked about preparing for my treatment, is talking about getting all the other doctors involved. Letting my blood sugar doctor, my endocrinologist know that I was going for cancer treatment. Were there any issues involving my blood sugar medicine? Letting my cardiologist know what was going on and what cardiology medicine I was on, and was there any danger with that? And pretty much getting everybody involved so that all of my medical professionals were involved in my treatment, and that way could avoid any issues. Chemotherapy drugs often work by blocking cancer cells from copying themselves. We know how cells replicate, right? At the DNA, they start to split apart, they become new cells, and so on and so on. They keep growing. Cancer cells can't stop. Usually cells grow till you don't need anymore, and then they just quit growing. They quit replicating, basically. Cancer cells don't do that. They just keep going. That's what causes the lump. Chemotherapy drugs often work by blocking cancer cells from copying the DNA and replicating. This means they can help stop cancer cell from dividing, making a new cancer cell. And as the cancer cells die off, they're not able to continue building themselves up and spreading. My particular treatment for my chemo is I took a drug called cisplatin one day a week for 6 weeks via an IV. So cisplatin is in a family of drugs that's used to fight testicular, ovarian, throat, cervical, and even lung cancer. It's one of the most commonly used chemotherapy drugs in the fight against cancer. So it's certainly not an unknown drug. They use that fairly regularly. It's pretty safe. The entire process took 3 to 4 hours once a week just for the chemotherapy. And this is if I did my blood test on the Saturday before my chemo day, which was Monday. This was to monitor my blood work, kidney function, liver function. And that was to make sure I was all clear to go ahead and take the chemotherapy or have the chemotherapy done. Once they were cleared to proceed with that, they would insert a butterfly needle into the vein of the day, whichever vein seemed to be easiest to get a needle into. I had a butterfly needle set put in each elbow, back of the hands, wrists, just back of the wrist, you name it. I probably had a needle put there somewhere in my extremities. There was even talk at least once of putting one in my foot. I wasn't real big on that one to get away from that. Anyway, so yeah, we had to put that in. Once they got the needle in, I'd be given about a liter of fluids to make sure I was properly hydrated before we started everything up. This was to get to make sure the system was working, make sure my body was working right. So we would get that liter of fluids in, and then they would administer the cisplatin. So approximately 30 minutes to get the cisplatin. Let me turn that off. So once I finished the liter, which is about 20, 30, 35 minutes, I would be given the cisplatin, and that would be administered. And that would take about 45 minutes, 30, 45 minutes, if I remember right, the cisplatin would be put in. So once they got that going, then the cisplatin would be administered. After that, the cisplatin was again followed by 2 liters of fluids, sometimes 3, depending on how if I was dehydrated or whatever, what they felt they needed to do to keep my body functioning. And this was to help push all of the drugs or the chemo out of my system, help clean the kidneys, help clean the liver, clean out the bladder, everything else, to get all that stuff and flush it from my system. You don't want it to build up inside there. That's what starts causing the renal problems and the renal failure. So initially, the first 2 to 3 weeks, I was just mostly tired and didn't feel very good after I would have the treatment. I was functional, but I just didn't feel good. I was tired. But once we got to that 3rd week mark, 4th week mark, I not only felt tired, I started feeling really exhausted after that. Started getting nauseous, not like vomiting, but just nauseous. Just did not feel good. Feel like I always had an upset stomach. Thank God we were doing IVs, because I sure couldn't swallow anything by then. And of course, as people who know me will tell you, I was getting kind of irritable at that point as well. Did not want to do things that they wanted me to do just because I was being irritable and hard-headed. And since from the beginning I wasn't eating properly, using my feeding tube properly, I became dehydrated and malnourished. And that didn't help with my overall physical, mental, and even emotional state at times. When you're hungry, you're thirsty, your body's craving something, but you're not really hungry, you're running chemicals through your system, it just messes with your head, messes with your mind, messes with your emotional health, messes certainly with your physical health, weaker and weaker, etc. And that leads to all sorts of issues. That's kind of what my chemotherapy was like. So on Mondays when I would finish that chemo, about a 4-hour day, once I would finish that 4-hour day, the next step was to go down and we'd start radiation therapy. So that's what I would do. Down the steps we go and we start radiation. And that's going to be next week's video to talk about that. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you later.